Ipsen's new biotech facility in Massachusetts signals a significant step for the European Pharmaceutical Group. The company has history in the Boston area since the 70s, forging partnerships with U.S. scientific, medical, and academic centers. It's Ipsen's well-established mission to target research and technological advances in medical products. Its research programs focus on the discovery of innovative products in three disease areas: oncology, endocrinology, and neuromuscular disorders, with one clear-cut aim: innovation for patient care. It's a mission that's heartfelt company-wide.
We are very much conscious of the fact that our mission in life, if you will, as a corporate organization, is to contribute to helping the patient feel better whenever they are confronted with a pathological condition. So whenever we work at implementing some research programs, or we always keep in mind the fact that, you know, we are not working in a non-human environment, if you will. We are very much focused on whatever the patient needs are.
Ipsen's new Bioprocess Sciences Research Center joins the R&D Center in the Boston area, adding strength to the company's worldwide presence and reflects the group's dedication to specific technological platforms such as peptide engineering, protein engineering, medicinal chemistry, and drug delivery. Ipsen's new 38,000-foot biotech facility houses high-tech biotechnology labs, research offices, state-of-the-art utilities, and manufacturing space. Here, the Ipsen team will produce recombinant proteins for clinical development. Ipsen and Octagen have teamed up to create a breakthrough treatment of congenital and acquired hemophilia in certain patients. The OB1 and OB2 product concept was first invented by Dr. Pete Lawler, a professor at Emory University and a certified hematologist. Lawler and his lab are collaborating with Ipsen in developing the products.
There is some kind of a long history between, you know, the hemophilia medical condition and Ipsen. In this regard, we are working on two research programs as we speak in the hemophilia area. And we have decided that we would dedicate some very significant industrial investments to that vision that of ours. We have one medical compound in development, which is a recombinant porcine factor 8, which we have been doing research on quite actively over the recent years, and we've decided to create the industrial platform to support, you know, the evolution of that program here in Massachusetts.
It is called OB1 that could soon end the suffering with a particularly stubborn form of hemophilia. To understand the significance of this pharmaceutical development, it is important to understand the disease, hemophilia. There are about 17,000 people in the United States with hemophilia, symptoms varying from bruising and joint pain to prolonged bleeding. Hemophilia is a hereditary bleeding disorder linked to the male gene, a disease caused by a deficiency or complete absence of a blood protein essential for blood to clot. Take a look at what happens in normal blood clotting compared to what doesn't happen in a hemophiliac's blood. Within seconds of an injury, tiny cells in the blood called platelets bunch together around the wound. Blood proteins, platelets, calcium, and other tissue factors react together and form a clot, which acts like a plug in the wound, stopping the bleeding. For people with hemophilia, clotting factors are missing or don't work as they should, and therefore a plug is never formed in a wound or injury. Without factor 8 protein, clotting doesn't occur. The bleeding won't stop. Treatment exists to introduce factor 8 protein to hemophiliacs, but approximately 25% treated with factor 8 develop immunity against factor 8, and treatments no longer work. Essentially, the patient's blood develops antibodies that neutralize factor 8, rendering the current treatment ineffective. Sometimes, but rarely, people with no hemophilia problems develop antibodies against their own factor 8, causing the same problems. Ipsen's new drug, OB1, seeks to solve these problems because OB1 does not interact with these antibodies, and OB1 replaces the patient's missing protein to clot the blood normally. Ipsen uses recombinant DNA technology, modern cell culture, and protein production technologies to make OB1, recombinant porcine factor 8. Recombinant DNA technology is a well-established genetic modification technique used to produce new medicines and life-saving vaccines. Here's how Ipsen is using the latest advances in biotechnology to create OB1 for the treatment of hemophilia. We extract a piece of DNA from pig cells after determining the exact sequence of DNA that is coding for the factor VIII protein. The piece of that DNA is inserted into animal cells, in this case, the cell isolated from the baby hamster kidney, where the cells with the inserted DNA are propagated using advanced cell culture technology. In other words, the growing of cells outside of a living organism. With the favorable culturing conditions, the cells transcribe the DNA message for the porcine factor VIII and process it as their own through their protein synthesis machinery. The use of these technologies allows the rapid replication in only 1 or 2 days of the genetically manipulated cells, including the DNA inserted. In such a way, a large amount of factor VIII is produced by the cells serving as the protein factories. Now, it is important to note that we still have to separate the recombinant factor VIII protein from the other proteins and materials in this process. Chromatography is one of the main separation techniques used. Think of it like an obstacle course created for the proteins to run through. Then scientists can choose the correct protein, factor VIII, that meets certain criteria. Once the correct protein is purified, it can be injected into humans to replace the missing factor VIII protein to enable blood coagulation in thousands of people suffering from hemophilia.
The process starts with the thawing of an ampule of our cells. It's a mammalian cell-based process. And the inoculum is frozen in liquid nitrogen in order to maintain it in a viable state for years and years and years, the duration of the life cycle of the product.
Then, the cells are counted and examined under a microscope and placed in an incubator where they are allowed to grow for 3 to 4 days. Cells are inoculated into slightly larger flasks and the process continues until there are enough cells to start the large-scale production. A transfer occurs to a roller bottle that is delivered in a sterile environment to the next room called the cell culture room. That's where the robot, named D'Artagnan, takes over.
The robot takes the human factor out of the equation. So it is sitting inside a highly controlled cabinet where the air is highly pure. And any potential contaminant that might be in the air is swept quickly out of that cabinet. So the robot can open bottles and add medium without fear of getting it contaminated.
During this part of the process, the fluid is exchanged and ultimately, the cells from one roller bottle expand to 10 roller bottles, each time placed back into the incubator. Then from 10 roller bottles to 50 roller bottles until there are 500 roller bottles, this process lasts for 6 days. Each day, the culture fluid is captured and sent to the next room where it is purified. The purification process and the analysis of the product occurs several times to ensure the product is free from bacteria and meets exact criteria. What you can't see is the incredible cleansing of the air throughout the lab to adhere to very strict standards.
The air quality that surrounds the product once it's in a clean room is highly cleansed and characterized. The air pressure in each of the clean rooms is maintained at a slightly higher pressure than the hallways so that if a door opens, clean air constantly goes out of the room instead of going in the room.
And all throughout the facility, computers carefully monitor everything, including airflow, water quality, and temperature, with a supervising facility engineer on duty during the entire production. From monitoring to scientists and researchers, Ipsen has 600 people assigned to R&D with real-life connections.
They are not scientists isolated in their labs and doing great science, totally disconnected from their environment. No, they are very, very close to the medical community and the patient community, and they feel part of it.
Ipsen is proud to have secured several major business agreements in the past 3 years with the leading names in the pharmaceutical industry on a global scale. and company growth continues to expand. As for the treatment of hemophiliacs with Ipsen's OB1, it is in phase 2 clinical trials.
We just hope that it saves lives. If it does that, we're happy.